couple receives the most unusual gift from their son on their 60th wedding anniversary. Visualize a day when you've been gifted the thing you've been craving to own for a long time. Happy, aren't you? Of course, any one of us would be. This happiness multiplies manifold when it comes from our beloved. Something similar happens in this story. Joel Smith was very happy to see his parents' wedding video. Their happy and cheerful, wrinkle-free faces took him to the past days when his parents were young and energetic. While looking at the wedding video, his eyes caught something interesting. After looking at that, he could figure out exactly what he wishes to gift his parents on their wedding anniversary. Read and hear about the interesting thing which Joel gifted his parents. Their love story was no less than a roller coaster ride. Maybe it takes you also down the memory lane where you two were gifted something special. Joe Smith, Joel's father, was an athlete at school. He was an active member of the school sports team. The entire school was crazy about his masculine physique. His endurance and physical strength were what the teachers would praise. His skills were commendable, and he was a great competitor to other sportspersons at school. He was the heartthrob of the majority of the girls there. Beverly Smith, Joel's mother, was the cheerleader at the school. She would be encouraging and applauding at the sports events. Beverly has cheered often for Joe. He was the finest player and deserved the cheer. Beverly was a cute teenager who was an extrovert. Her smile stole many hearts. She would be the talk of the town and the entire school. These two opposite poles were attracted to each other, and there it was when it all began. Joe was the man of the match for almost all the events, and Beverly, who was also cheering for him, got together in high school. The heartthrob of the school found the calming smile for his life. They could be seen hanging out together at school parades and functions. Everyone thought that it would have been a random infatuation, which would not last long, but destiny had something else in store for them. These high school sweethearts were sure that it was not just infatuation, but something more. After going around for about 1 year, Joe finally proposed to Beverly. She was shocked for an instant, but she too wanted it badly. Beverly happily accepted his proposal. If you're wondering what next, then you'll be delighted to know that other special plans Joe had for his lover. Joe and Beverly were soon tied in an official relationship. Joe wanted to make this day even special by gifting her something she would cherish all her life. And Joe gifted her something that would be becoming a life-changing part of their lives, something neither of them would be able to forget. Years later, a detail about that gift is highlighted in their wedding video, which led to an astonishing happening. Their love didn't fade away, rather it bloomed with every passing day. Joe and Beverly got married to one another in the year 1953. They were barely 19 years then, but wished to taste the wedding bliss as early as possible. They were eager to step into the future together in New York. All the concerned family and friends who attended their wedding ceremony at the church made sure to shoot it on camera properly. Their love story was a perfect example to many, and everyone was looking forward to their married life. But then a drastic change took place which affected their lives in a manner they never thought. Have you ever felt the frustration when you want the time to pass fast, but it takes even longer than usual? Similarly, Joe and Beverly were way too excited to begin their new life, but something dangerous took place abroad. The US military had been embroiled in a conflict with Korea, and it was getting even worse. Though initially it had no direct impact on their lives, soon it brought a turmoil in their lives. Right in the beginning of their marital phase, the fate intervened. Joe was called for military service in the US and he had to leave immediately. Little did the couple know that they would have to wait even longer to enjoy their wedding present and attach memories to it. They were married for a very small period of time, and Joe's leaving for the military camp broke their innocent hearts. As they say, love finds its way even in the hardest times. After all, a lotus always blooms in a swamp. Joe prepared for his military camp. It was obvious that he would be a part of the conflict with Korea. The young, happily married couple had to now make themselves ready for Joe's departure. It was even more hard for Joe to leave Beverly behind alone in the city. While they were just managing to cope with all these sudden changes which took place in their fresh life, a bigger change burdened them. the couple had to sell some of their most prized possessions to make ends meet in Joe's absence. It took away with it something which meant a lot to the couple. What was that special thing? Yes, you read that right, a long-distance marriage and not a long-distance relationship. After Joe left for his duty, the only way this newlywed couple communicated was via letters and telegrams. They would be telling their well-being and hoped that their spouse was healthy too. The cute little things make a difference in our lives, and Joe and Beverly made sure they left no chance of making their partner feel special. They would be sharing their photographs from the past and would relive those memories, sitting very far from one another. Isn't it cute? But that was not it. Finally, months of waiting and long distance was over, and the couple reunited. Joe and Beverly were back to their basics and could, at last, begin with their married life, the way they planned. Joe returned to America safely from the war. Joe and Beverly lived the life they desired. They had kids who grew up to become responsible and successful adults. Their kids were brought up hearing a story which was no less than a fairy tale. What was this story which snapped their parents' youthfulness into responsibilities? It was celebration time for the Smiths. Today was their 60th wedding anniversary celebration. Their children and grandchildren planned a surprise party for them. All near and dear friends were a part of the celebration to celebrate a milestone that this head-over-heels love-infused couple had achieved. The couple was absolutely unaware of the surprise which their friends had planned for them. What was that surprise which would make their special day even more special? While everyone planned something or the other to gift the Smiths as a wedding anniversary present, Joel, the son, still could not figure it out, what he wishes to gift his parents. He wanted to present them something which would be precious to them. But what? That was still the question. Then something happened which gave him the idea of what he could give them. And I bet you will be delighted to see his parents' expressions when he presented them with that gift. We all are amused at the sight of ourselves in old pictures. We probably look ugly and fat and are left ashamed. Surely they are the blast from the past. Something alike was the couple's surprise. Their friends had arranged a video of their wedding day itself. Joe and Beverly relived their precious moments. It was the perfect day to reminisce about their wedding day. While everyone was watching the video and smiling at the couple's faces, there was something which caught their son Joel's eye. While Joel's parents were nostalgic after witnessing their wedding video, his eyes were dazzled at the sight of a detail standing next to his parents in that video. While everything was dazzling worthy, as it was the first time he was watching that wedding video, who was that someone special that got Joel's eyes glued at it? Joel even whispers, "Oh, she was the red one." Well, who got Joel's undivided attention was someone who played a vital part in his parents' lives. She was the one whom he was brought up hearing in his parents' stories about. Well, to curb your curiosity, let me tell you, it was not a woman in red, but it was something beautiful in itself. It was his parents' beloved. It was nothing else but a 1948 Plymouth convertible, something everyone craved to own then. Joel grew up hearing that his parents owned one Plymouth Super Deluxe. They had many memories attached to it. But why was this car so special? Why did Joel's eyes catch the sight of a car he already knew about? Surely there was a lot more to this luxurious car. This hot rod was extremely special as it was that engagement present which Joe gifted Beverly when he proposed to her. It was not easy to own this car then. Joe was way too young to buy one. While he was in high school, he started saving to purchase one. He even told his mom to help him out with this. His mom happily helped him out on the condition that Joe would pay her his future checks. Finally, they purchased the car in 1953, but they weren't aware what was going to happen to their beloved Plymouth hot rod. Joe and Beverly had every reason to flaunt their car then. This car had witnessed different phases of their life, be it as high school lovers, the newly engaged, or the newlywed couple. It had seen it all, but this car could not witness them turning into parents. When Joe had to leave for the military war with Korea, they sold some of their possessions. In those possessions, they sold this special car as well. Their beloved hot rod was not a part of their journey after that day. But their journey did not end there. Joel was yet to surprise them. While watching the wedding video, even Joel's eyes were not dry. He recalls his childhood days, where some of his earliest memories were not of him, but that of his parents. They would consistently remind their kids about a car they once owned. It was the car which physically marked their official togetherness in that area. This car was no less than a family member in itself. Years later, while watching this video, he was struck with an incredible idea that he could put to action now. Joel finally got the thing which he wanted to gift his parents as a wedding anniversary present. He was sure he will be gifting his parents the 1948 Plymouth convertible. The car which had given his parents so much will now again become part of their journey. He could see how many emotions of his parents were invested in that video, and especially on that Plymouth. But from where and how will Joel find this vintage 1948 Plymouth convertible in the 21st century? Finding a Plymouth was a really challenging task in front of Joel now. The car was now a vintage and must have been overpriced. Joel couldn't find any. After meeting various collectors, he came to know that there were three of these available, of which two were already sold and the remaining one left was gracing a museum. Joel did not lose his hope and carried with his search for finding one. After hours and days of research online, Joel managed to find one Plymouth convertible online. The ad that was posted guaranteed the car to be in the best condition possible. Joel wished to visit the seller to strike a deal with him regarding a car which would surely leave his parents amazed. It would give them their lost happiness, but things did not seem to work this easy. According to the seller, the car was in excellent condition and was safeguarded in a garage for almost a decade. It had never been taken out in winters and sported a fine shape. It was the 1948 Plymouth convertible, which was shining the same way it used to be back in 1948. Moreover, it also had a very low mileage. Then what was the problem? The Craigslist ad had no pictures of the car, and just a written description was given. Joel was not sure of whether it will be the same car as pictured in his parents' wedding video. The owner of the car was an 81-year-old man who was not good with technology and thus could not send pictures. He was from Indiana. Joel, after having a word with him, asked one of his friends to visit that seller and investigate about the car. Next, what happened just blew Joel away. After arriving in Indiana, Joel's friend assured him about the Plymouth. He told Joel that the product is exactly what he's looking for. It was a worthy investment. To make Joel even more confident about the purchase, his friend sent him enough snapshots of the car from various angles. The seller had all the documents relating to the car at hand. He even had the maintenance records and the original manual of this luxury. In short, it was the same and an original model of the 1948 Plymouth convertible. Joel made the purchase of the car which was more than a car to his parents, something they had strong ties with, yet he was still not prepared for his parents' reaction to it. The car was delivered to New York, all the way from Indiana. Joel could not believe his eyes. It was exactly the same car he wanted. It was right in front of his eyes. He could not believe his eyes. It was no less than a dream come true. But then came another hindrance. Where would he hide this car? Hiding it from his parents was a challenge. There was no place in his own property where Joel could hide the car, escaping his father's eyes. Then came Donnie, a local dealer of cars in the neighborhood. He was Joel's friend. He luckily knew a place where he could hide the car. But Joel's dad, that is Joe Smith, knew everyone in town and even Donnie. He often visited Donnie, so he could find the car there as well. Now what? They hid it in a garage at the local dealer's place. Donnie gave the car a little pampering. He did all the final touch-ups that were needed, making it stand out from all other cars. Meanwhile, Joel was planning out the manner in which he would surprise his parents. He wanted to make this revelation a big and surprising one, but how was the question? Colby, Joel's son and Joe's grandson, was the best one to trigger this surprise game. Joel explained the entire plan to his son. It was a part of the plan that Colby would ask his grandparents to go on a fishing trip just the way they had been going for it before. It was a foolproof plan. Joe and Beverly were excited to find their grandson at their place, but they had absolutely no clue what was coming their way. Colby was enjoying his so-called stay at his grandparents' place, while Joel was all ready to present them with their very own 1948 Plymouth convertible. Colby was inside the house with a hidden camera shooting every detail of the plan. Joel took the car out of Donnie's garage and drove it to his parents' house. The old parents could not even imagine what they were going to find today. Colby could himself not wait for his father, Joel Smith, to reach his grandparents' house. He too was eager to see them smile. He wanted to capture their reaction. The grandson and the son both couldn't wait to present this couple with one of the gifts they had the special memories attached with. Finally, the wait was over. Colby had one eye on his grandparents and the other one on the window. He wanted to make sure that when he finds his father with a car, he'll execute his plan. Joel was there with the car, and Colby shouted with enthusiasm, "Look outside, Grandpa. Just look outside through the window." What happened next was surely going to make this couple's day. The old couple went towards the window, and what they saw next took them to a dream world. They could not believe their eyes. It was a 1948 Plymouth convertible. The car which had witnessed their youthful days, their developing love story, and above all, it was the memory to their wedding day. Colby followed them, and Joel waited for his parents at the car's front seat. The next minute was going to mark this day as a memorable one in Smith's calendar. Initially, Joe and Beverly could not control their emotions looking at this car. It was indeed a nostalgic moment for them. But returning back to their senses, they could not understand as to what this car was doing in their house's driveway. Joel stepped out of the car and spoke out the words which took the couples on cloud nine. Joel handed over the keys to his father, Joe. Joe couldn't understand what was going on, and then Joel said, "Dad, it's yours. This 1948 Plymouth convertible is a wedding anniversary present to you from all of us." For a second, Joe could not believe his ears. The car, which was given away due to certain circumstances, is back. All those memories associated with the car were revived. Joe's reaction after this was something which would probably be the most pleasing sight to any child. While Beverly was lost in her days of the past after looking at the car, Mr. Joe broke down in tears at its sight. The sight of this car after almost 40 years brought back with it a lot. The innocent days of the couple's love and marriage, their drifting apart with this car, were all running in his mind, just like a flashback. Joe was touching the car from every angle to believe that yes, he was actually living this beautiful dream. Joe and Beverly felt an array of emotions at that moment. It was not just a car, it was a four-wheeler packed with their memories from the past. Joe expressed his heartfelt gratitude towards Joel, his son. In his words, no one could have gifted them something better than this car as a gift. That too, as a wedding anniversary present. This car made the couple's day, something which Joel wanted to happen. There was no stopping the couple. Once they wiped off the tears, they took off in this car, in their very own car. The adventure was about to begin. While Joel and Colby watched the oldest members of their family relive their beautiful past, the couple drove off to the countryside. If you're wondering what happened to this car next, then hold your breath, as it was. This 1948 Plymouth convertible was a special one for the family. Not only had this car witnessed the love story of the oldest couple of the Smiths family, but also will witness the upcoming generations as well. The family titled the car as the Love Car. How just a single clue from the wedding video made the couple's life a beautiful one is just amazing. Joel undoubtedly is the best son anyone can have.